What up, gamers? Fence here, and welcome back to Shadowverse. So last time, we did Joy, Will and Power, and Denial, and we're now gonna finish off Urias' story with Rage in the next act. So Rage over here, after Urias defeats the soldiers, Balthazar appears before him again. My gosh, are we gonna fight Balthazar again? Jeez, how many times now? I just want to fight Nexus, man. Like, I'm all on board with Urias' desires now to fight Nexus.
The priestess is trying to butcher me. Fall, dead monster! Your mockeries of blades are like splinters before me. They are helpless to defeat me. Surely you do not plan to flee again. You are the keeper of this place, are you not? Do not be afraid to speak. Your lie is foremond. You pathetic monstrosity. All alone in the world. I shall fell you where you stand! Ha! Such ridiculousness! Balthazar was a man unlike any other. How dare you use his image in such a way? Prepare yourself, Urias! Enough! You will anger me no further.
Alright, here we go. Yeah, dude. I gotta say, you know, so far, even though this is the last video for Urias until we play as him again
at
some point.
You will anger me no further!
Urias Formond, the last of the vampires!
Yeah, Urias' story is more about, like, his personality rather than his actual backstory. It seems like he just fights anyone, you know? Doesn't matter if it's a vampire or not, like his own kind.
I shall fail you!
But yeah, right now I don't think we have a good start. Oh no. Yeah, I don't feel like we got a good start here. Conjure Golem. Ooh. Yeah, not a really great start.
This is the world for which you wished.
Yeah, it's got a mixture of runecraft and bloodcraft, it seems.
Shed tears of joy, I've arrived. Me? Really?
No, it's okay. Ooh. Should we do this? I mean, I really want to keep that fanfare.
Shed tears of joy, I've arrived.
Then we can do a Scarlet Vampire.
Me? Really?
Dang, it's just a bunch of effect damage. Yeah, not the most exciting of battles right now.
I'll slice you to ribbons!
All right.
Hey, watch this!
It's gonna evolve.
Don't let me down.
I feel like I could fly.
I'm falling apart.
All right. Oh, we got two of these. Let's go with you. Try to draw some more cards here. I mean, I guess we can evolve, or should we evolve this? Because I don't like that golem there.
You will soon learn.
You are a total brat.
Okay, we'll see how this goes.
There is breath in my lungs yet.
Oh my.
I'll make your wishes reality.
I feel like I could fly.
Okay.
So not gonna lose next time.
Good cards, no good cards. Shoot. Ooh, I think I want to keep that still.
I'll slice you to ribbons.
I won't move next time.
Let's get our vengeance out again.
Nonsense.
Ouch.
Our swords will cross the
oh,
line.
You better not get Storm somehow. Oh, yep, I knew it. Oh, wow, okay, hold on. This is gonna be tough, guys. I just lost here.
Only the just.
Ooh.
It will take more to destroy me.
He's got a Runeblade Summoner deck. There we go, our first loss as Urias. Wow. Ooh, we gotta play this again. Dang, okay. Yeah, we gotta be fast now. Yeah, I see his deck now. Dang, I think I remember this deck too. I think I remember this deck when I first played Shadowverse from like way back when.
Urias Formond, the last of the vampires.
Yeah, I think I remember just how scared I was about the Runeblade Summoner that I would make a deck based on her because of this battle. That was like one of my first times playing Shadowverse.
Allow me to bestow a crimson kiss.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, screw that guy. Gain some health back. Yeah, we got 3 wrath now, which is cool.
That was delightful.
But yeah, he's really trying to build up that Runeblade Summoner. Dude, I need my Urias.
Your tragedy has begun.
I really do want my Urias. What shall we do here?
I won't hurt you. Too much. Allow me to bestow a crimson kiss.
Maybe we can evolve him so that we can get some health back.
You will soon learn.
My blade will melt under my touch.
It can't end here.
There we go. How is our wrath right now? Oh, we're at 5.
Delightful.
Don't let me down.
Yeah, dude, where's Urias when you need him? Oh, jeez. You know what? Destroy these two. No Urias yet. That is unfortunate. But yeah, dude, this deck is so scary. He probably has like a bunch of those Runeblade Summoners now or something. Oh, dude, we gotta be faster than him, though. We gotta make sure we can
weakness the power.
Deplete his health as, like, faster than him.
I'll slice you to ribbons.
He's down by 7 now.
There is breath in my lungs yet.
He returns. Okay, so we can't summon the Runeblade right now.
Your tragedy has begun.
Okay, good. You summon your second Laura. Ooh, we're so close to winning, actually. We're so close. Hold on, can I play any good cards? I can evolve him, deal 6 damage, but do you think this will be good too? What does she do? Hold on. Whenever a allied Bloodcraft, Forcecraft bat, or Forest Bat comes into play, deal 1 damage to the enemy leader. This might win us the match.
Stay with me all night.
There we go, we won.
Let us conclude.
Yeah, let's conclude, man.
There won't be a stabby stab.
Ooh. Alright, Don't have to worry about the Runeblade Summoner.
Away! Make a mockery of him no more!
Alright, are we gonna finally fight Nexus now?
How unsatisfactory. Liberating the world, making others dream. Such foolishness. So infantile, so puerile. Perhaps you are a god, but you are not a worthy opponent. I have already lingered too long. Let us bring this dream to a conclusion.
The outside world is consumed by sorrow. Why do you insist on proceeding?
Because I do not wish to stagnate or degenerate. Away with you!
Alright, one last battle now. So what, are we going to fight Balthasar again? It seems like there's no end to Balthasar. The next act. Urias confronts Eris, who foretells the end of the world. So yeah, I guess they are going to destroy the world. Okay, it looks like we're not going to be fighting Nexus, but Eris instead, which is pretty disappointing. But yeah, I was hoping for like at least one fight with Nexus. That'll be fun.
I have had enough of your god serenity. Show yourself!
And then there's the real Eris.
At last you appear. But how much can I expect from Nexus if she surrounds herself with minions like you?
What so enamors you of fighting, last of the vampires? You seem to be hunting for something, but what?
One born so fragile as you could scarcely understand. I was born mighty, and all was simple for me, too simple. That is why I sought. I sought for a reason to exist. I kept searching until I found it, in the heat of battle. Only when battling the powerful do I truly exist. To battle is to breathe.
So I feel like that's his backstory.
And so it was for the others of your kind. Those prideful beasts consumed human beings.
Perhaps I too am prideful, but tell me, how is this different from you and your god? Is pride not the privilege of the mighty?
For her, it is justified. The almighty Nexus is no...
Who demanded that you liberate this world? Who wished for this dream of serenity?
Sorrow is consuming the world. That much is clear to all who look.
Enough of your preposterous talk! You already know that your beliefs are mistaken.
I wanted to liberate the world, to free the people from despair and sorrow.
You should not have assumed that all the world was seeking the same liberation as you.
Yeah.
My life is not yours to define.
The path I chose was not...
It no longer matters whether you were correct. Lead me to Nexus. I warn you that refusal is not an option.
Yeah, that was pretty interesting. Because, yeah, he was, like, questioning her and, like, you know.
I intend to make my own way.
The path I chose was not...
Like, who decided to... What was it? Who decided to do the whole liberation thing? And it seems like that's the will of Eris here. And even though she has good intentions, not everyone... Not everyone, like, follows the same way.
I won't hurt you.
But yeah, dude, I really like Urias. You know, with Urias here, we don't... Yeah, like I said before, we don't really get a lot of backstory.
As promised.
Yeah, we don't really get a lot of backstory with Urias here.
Too much.
But, like, I feel like that's okay because... He's very much like a straightforward character, you know?
As promised. As promised. Bridge of Collie's fate is
not a sweet time.
Ooh, do I really want to play this? Restore 8 defense. I mean, I'd rather draw. Okay, we'll just save it.
My boss works up to the
But yeah, Urias here is definitely a different character.
You are done for.
When it comes to his character being told.
My wings are killing me. I'm still hungry.
Like, he found his purpose in life. That he wants to battle and all that.
Shed tears of joy, I've arrived.
There we go. Should we evolve?
You will soon learn.
I think we can evolve just one time. That's fine.
Evil. Kneel as promised.
Great battle.
You've got to see me dance.
I shall protect you.
The real battle begins.
No misfortune will harm you.
Ooh. Gonna make more space. Yikes. But that's okay. Let's go Scarlet Vampire.
I'll slice you to ribbons.
No! Break.
Should we evolve? I can deal damage of 4. If I evolve, I can do 6. I don't know. Because, like, what if I get Urias?
As promised.
Can't evolve. We'll see how this plays out. It would be nice to get Urias back. Get more cards to draw. Urias, come on. No. Where is Urias? There he is. But I can't really finish things off like this, though. I think I need to survive one more turn. Well, I mean, no, I can just finish her off like that, but... Should I do a challenge? Should I do a challenge where... I want to end things off with Urias here. But how do I do that? Especially since I don't have enough play points to pull off something like this.
Stabby, stabby!
This is like a puzzle. I also want to recover my health too. Okay, Dude, I'm like... I'm trying to think this through. Okay, so how many cards do we have that can deal damage to the enemy leader? We got one here. Where whenever an enemy follower is destroyed, deal 1 damage to the enemy leader. I mean, maybe we can make it work, but we only have one. Okay. Well, I think what I want to do here is to try to survive one more turn. I will try to survive one more turn. So unless she has something crazy that can deal 10 damage to me, then yeah, maybe I might be sad. I don't know. Yeah, I don't think that's going to be enough. There we go. Urias! I believe it's time now. Let's make this a dramatic ending.
Weakness the power. Lose yourself in this final dance.
Alright. Let's go do, which one shall we do? I guess it doesn't matter since this will be my final turn. Okay. There we go. Maybe what we can do is... maybe attack 1.
Stop.
Oh, did I not win? Oh, I should have done it 2 times. Well, I was very close to end things off with Urias here. No, we can do 1 more turn. 1 more turn. 1 more turn.
You are free, my dog.
What? Storm? Okay. We're still okay. Urias, you're still the victor.
Weak.
Okay.
Your determination. mission.
We won. All right, that felt very satisfying in a sense.
Ha! You are fragile indeed.
All right, we did it, guys. We did it.
Your thirst for victory is waning. What difference is left between you and the imposters?
I don't know anymore. Why have you done this to me?
Was he able to change her mind?
Ha! To worry and flounder is the privilege of the weak. Make the most of it.
There is, however, one thing of which I'm still sure. You have no need for this world.
Does Nexus lie beyond you?
Yes. She is prepared to extinguish the world at this very moment.
In that case, I must pay her a visit. Farewell, weak one. The imposters have reached their end. Farewell, Balthazar. And now to test the worth of Nexus. May it be the true challenge I have thirsted for.
And I believe that's it. Yeah. Alright guys, so yeah, that was Urias' story. I gotta say, very, very interesting. At least for me it was. Then yeah, once again, we'll see that for next time. So yeah, that was Urias' story. Next time, we'll do Eris's. I gotta say though, I feel like after doing Urias's, we start to get maybe some more information on Eris here. On like her purpose. Because yeah, it just seems like she wants to, you know, she basically wants to eliminate all despair and stuff in the world. And for, it seems like the only way to do that is to destroy the world. But then you got someone like Urias here, like, saying like, do the people really want that though? And then I guess that made her pretty guilty and made her rethink her ways. I'm gonna guess that Eris is responsible for Nexus being a thing. But yeah, that's my guess. I'm very much looking forward to, you know, seeing Eris' story over here to see what it's all about. Because yeah, once again, she just feels like, you know, one of those behind the scenes things. You know, she feels like a point of view that we can see from the villain, from the Nexus side of things. But anyway, guys, yeah, can't wait to play her story. Maybe we'll also figure out why there's like a blue-eyed Eris and all that when over here the normal version of her has the red or pink eyes. But yeah, guys, Urias here, very interesting as a character. I did like his story a lot. But yeah, guys, that'll be it for now. That's game.